If you're taking the HiSET exam, then you're going to see a lot of word problems. Here's an example of the type of word problem you'll see when you take the HiSET. Mrs. Patterson's classroom has 16 empty chairs. Notice how they didn't actually put the number, they spelled it out. So they're hoping you'll miss that. Read carefully. All the chairs are occupied when every student is present. If 2/5 of the students are absent, how many students make up her entire class? Okay, so here they gave us this ratio or fraction that we can use. And it's 2 out of every 5 students are absent. So you have 2 absent to 5 total. Using this ratio and this third piece of information, we can set up a proportion. We have 16 empty chairs. They're empty because there are 16 students absent. Make sure you are consistent when you set up proportions. So if your first ratio is 2 absent to 5 total, then your second ratio should be 16 absent to, and here's what we don't know, how many total. Now, there's more than one way to solve a proportion. Sometimes you'll get a proportion that lends itself, like this one does, to just figuring out a pattern. For instance, what do you do to 2 to get 16? Well, you just multiply times 8. So be consistent. Do the same thing to your denominator. 5 times 8 is 40. So there are 40 total students. That's not how you spell that word. Okay, but not all proportions can be solved that way. All proportions can, however, be solved with cross products. So let me show you how to do that. You just cross multiply. 2 times x is 2x, and the cross products of every proportion are equal, so that equals 5 times 16, which is 80, and then you simply solve for x. So divide both sides by 2, and you still get that x is 40, or that there are 40 total students in the class. There's an example of a word problem using a proportion to solve. Good luck on the HiSET. If you're planning on taking the HiSET exam, then you need to be ready for word problems. Here's an example of the type of word problem you'll see when you take the HiSET exam. Jamie had $6.50 in his wallet when he left home. He spent $4.25 on drinks and $2 on a magazine. Later, his friend repaid him $2.50 that he had borrowed the previous day. How much money does Jamie have in his wallet? Well, he's starting with $6.50. Then he spent $4.25, which means we need to take away $4.25 from the $6.50. So we subtract. That's $2.25. And $2 on a magazine. That's more money that he spent, so we need to take away another $2, which leaves him with just 25 cents. But then his friend repaid him $2.50, which means we added to the amount of money that he has. So we add $2.50, which gives him $2.75. So you just have to look for those keywords like spent and repaid to make sure that you're doing the right thing, either subtracting or adding, depending on what you're doing. There you have one example of the type of word problem you'll see when you take the HiSET exam. If you're planning to take the HiSET, then plan to work some word problems. Here's an example of the type of word problem you'll see when you take the HiSET. Rachel spent $24.15 on vegetables. She bought 2 pounds of onions, 3 pounds of carrots, and 1.5 pounds of mushrooms. If the onions cost $3.69 per pound, and the carrots cost $4.29 per pound, what is the price per pound of mushrooms? Okay, so let's start with our onions. She bought 2 pounds of onions, and the onions were $3.69 per pound. So her onions cost her $3.69 for each pound she bought, so times 2, which is $7.38. Her carrots, she bought 3 pounds of, and they were $4.29 per pound. So her carrots were $4.29 for each pound, and she bought 3 pounds of those. So that was $12.87. Now, let's add those together to find the total amount she spent on onions and carrots together. So the $7.38 plus $12.87, which is $20.25. And remember, you get to use a calculator on all of this, so don't worry about the actual multiplication or addition. Just type it in your calculator. Okay, so that's how much she spent on the onions and carrots. Since we're trying to find the price per pound of just the mushrooms, we need to take out what she spent on the onions and carrots from her total. So take her total, the $24.15, because that's for onions, carrots, and mushrooms, and take out the onions and carrots. So that what you're left with, the $3.90, is just what she spent on mushrooms. That's the total amount of money she spent on her mushrooms. Okay, so for the mushrooms, we're trying to find the price per pound. We have the price, $3.90. Per tells you to divide that by the number of pounds, and her mushrooms were 1.5 pounds. So divide that by 1 5/10 pounds. $3.90 divided by 1.5 pounds is $2.60 per pound. So that's her price per pound of mushrooms. There you have an example of the type of word problem you'll see when you take the HiSET. Good luck! If you're planning to take the HiSET exam, then you need to be comfortable with conversions. Here's an example of a conversion. A sailboat is 19 meters long. What is its length in inches? Well, we're starting with 19 meters. And I'm going to use what's called dimensional analysis to convert this. We have this chart here to help us. We want to convert meters first into centimeters so that we can convert our centimeters into inches. So to convert the meters, I need the meters unit to go away. To make the meters unit go away, put it in your denominator. That way the meters cross cancel. So 1 meter is how many centimeters? This one you have to know. It's not in your chart. 1 meter is 100 centimeters. Now, since we're trying to get inches, we need to convert these centimeters into inches. And that's where we'll use this chart. So again, we want to get rid of centimeters, so put your centimeters in your denominator. 2 5/400 centimeters is 1 inch. And by the way, each one of these is equal to 1. So you're taking your 19 meters and multiplying it times 1, which means you're not changing the value of your 19 meters. You're just changing how it's represented. Instead of in meters, you're representing it in inches. Okay, so your meters cross cancel, or let's do a different color. Your meters cross cancel, and your centimeters cross cancel, and we're left with the unit we were trying to get, which is inches. So now we just need to multiply. And although this looks kind of weird, these are all just fractions that we're multiplying together. If I took out these bars and just put time signs there, and you could put this one over one, you see we're just multiplying three fractions together. 19 times 100 times 1 is 1900 inches. And then 1 times 1 times 2 and 54 hundredths is 2 and 54 hundredths. Now all you have to do is divide 1900 by 2 and 54 hundredths, and that's where you get 748 inches. So, there you have one example of converting from one unit to another unit. Good luck on the HiSET exam. The HiSET exam will test you on your ability to read number lines and your knowledge of ratios. Here's an example that combines both of those skills that you'll need for the HiSET. In the figure, A, B, and C are points on the number line, where O is the origin. What is the ratio of the distance BC to distance AB? Well, ratios can be in many different forms, and you see the answer choices and how they're set up. So we'll set up our ratio the same way. And our ratio is distance BC to distance AB. So that'll be our ratio. Distance BC to distance AB. Now, for the distance from B to C, you can probably just count it on the number line. The distance between 5 and 8 is just 3. But there is a mathematical way of finding the distance between two points, and that's to find the absolute value of the difference of the two points. So, for instance, for B and C, it would just be 5 minus 8, the absolute value of 5 minus 8, or the absolute value of 8 minus 5. Either way, you'll get the same answer. 2, the distance of AB. So, same thing, we want to do the absolute value of the difference, and you can just go in order, negative 6 minus 5. Now we just need to simplify. So this would be the absolute value of negative 3 to the absolute value of negative 11. And the absolute value of negative 3 is 3. And the absolute value of negative 11 is 11. So your ratio is 3 to 11. That's one example of the type of problem you'll see when you take the HiSET.